Here at Infertility TV, we are believers in science and evidence-based medicine. When rumors started spreading that COVID vaccines would prevent embryos from implanting, it seemed weird to us since plenty of our vaccinated patients were getting pregnant. So we conducted a study and proved that COVID vaccines had no impact on the ability of an embryo to implant and did not increase the risk for miscarriage. That study was eventually accepted by a peer-reviewed medical journal and became the basis of new guidelines from the Center for Disease Control for couples interested in trying to become pregnant. You can view those guidelines using the link in the description. A funny thing happened though. We were so successful at disproving the myth about vaccines interfering with embryo implantation that new rumors started circulating that COVID mRNA vaccines were somehow magically sucked into the ovary, and that once there, would damage the ovary causing infertility. Does that really happen? Stay tuned for new results from the Infertility TV COVID Vaccine Infertility and Miscarriage Study. In the United States, two companies were able to produce COVID vaccines quickly using an amazing technology. Instead of trying to produce viral proteins in the laboratory, which takes a long time, they decided to use the virus's own strength against it. When a person is infected with SARS-CoV-2, the virus enters the cells and uses the cell's own machinery to duplicate the virus RNA, make proteins, and assemble new copies of the virus. The virus production would then destroy the cells, releasing the new virus copies, which would then go on to infect other cells. The COVID mRNA vaccines contain a small piece of the virus mRNA. It's the part that makes the spike protein which the virus needs to enter a cell. With the vaccine, the cells could briefly use the mRNA to make the spike protein. The body could then make antibodies against the spike protein, which would prevent the virus from getting into the cells, dramatically reducing the chance for infection and powerfully protecting people from severe illness, hospitalization, and death. mRNA treatment has been studied for decades. It was well accepted that mRNA treatments were safe and would make a great candidate for a vaccine. The big problem was that mRNA is so fragile, the companies couldn't find an inexpensive way to stabilize the mRNA long enough to get the vaccine from their lab and into the muscle cells in your arm. The big breakthrough with COVID vaccines was that these two companies finally figured out a way to keep the mRNA from breaking down. They encased the mRNA in a tiny bubble of cholesterol and lipids. The cell membranes of human cells are also made of lipids. Several months ago, one of the companies, Pfizer, submitted some data to the Japanese government when going through the vaccine approval process. They labeled the lipids in these little bubbles so that they could track what happened to them after injection. They used mice, not humans, for the tracking studies. The data was available on the internet in a table that was translated from the original Japanese. Some anti-vaxxers got hold of the table and posted it on Twitter and said, OMG, the lipid bubbles are being concentrated in the ovary. The lipid bubbles are toxic and will damage the eggs in the ovary so that nobody can get pregnant ever again. First of all, look at the table they posted. All of the organs are listed alphabetically. Here are the ovaries, and sure enough, it really looks like the ovary has more lipids accumulated than the other organs. But wait a minute, this table starts with the letter L for lymph nodes. Where are all the organs that start with the letters before L? Where's the injection site? Where's the liver? Doesn't the liver end up filtering most products in the body? Oh wait, they only showed half the table. Let's look at the rest of the table that they left out. Oh, here's the injection site and the liver. Let's look at this data in a graph, starting with the time of the injection here and over the next 48 hours. This looks at the concentration of lipids in all of these organs. It looks like the highest concentration is where you would expect, the injection site. Let's look at it another way. What percentage of the administered dose ends up in the different organs at the 48-hour mark? Here is the injection site. That makes sense that the majority of it ends up here. Here is the liver. Makes sense. The spleen also removes unwanted stuff from the body. Where are the ovaries? Oh, here they are. This tiny little insignificant amount. But what did the anti-vaxxers do here? To use a basketball analogy, they basically told you that Quinn Cook scores the highest average points per game on the LA Lakers. Well, as long as you don't count LeBron James, Anthony Davis, Dennis Schroeder, and like 12 other guys. Now, some of you anti-vaxxers out there are still saying, well, still, even that tiny, tiny, tiny amount is going to kill all of the eggs in the ovaries and make generations of women sterile. Fair enough? Let's see what the science says. In this study, researchers looked at women who had two IVF cycles, once before they were vaccinated and once after. There was no difference in the amount of medication that they needed to stimulate their ovaries, the number of days needed, their estrogen levels, the number of eggs retrieved, the number of mature eggs, the number of fertilized eggs, or the number of high-quality embryos. What about pregnancy rates? We looked at 310 couples with infertility who had frozen embryo transfers at the Naperville Fertility Center since January 2021. As part of our ongoing COVID vaccine study, every patient who has undergone IVF has a blood test for COVID antibodies. Based on those results, we divided them into three groups. Group one were women who did not have COVID antibodies. These are women who were not infected with COVID and did not receive a vaccine. Group two were women who were vaccinated before the eggs were retrieved. It takes time for the antibodies to become measurable. Forget about 48 hours. This means that the ovaries were exposed to the lipids for weeks to months before we extracted them. According to the anti-vaxxers, these are the women who would not be able to get pregnant. Group three were women who had a COVID infection before the eggs were retrieved. What were the pregnancy rates? Here they are. No difference was found in the chance for pregnancy, whether the ovaries had been exposed to the lipid bubbles in the vaccine or not. What was the risk for miscarriage, you ask? Also, no different. What's that, anti-vaxxers? These results aren't valid since during the IVF process, the eggs are removed from the ovaries, thus rescuing them in the IVF lab? Okay, we next looked at infertile couples who were attempting pregnancy using Clomid and good old-fashioned intercourse, or an IUI. Now, the eggs and embryos stay in the patient's body the entire time. We compared the pregnancy rates between vaccinated patients in the last year with 2 years of Clomid cycle data from before the pandemic began. Pregnancy rates and miscarriage rates were no different. Can't believe me because I am just some guy on YouTube with a lab coat? This data wasn't peer-reviewed? Wrong again. This data was reviewed and selected by fertility scientists for oral presentation at the International Meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine that was held in Baltimore in October in the late-breaking abstract session. What is the Infertility TV bottom line? There is no longer any lack of data. There isn't any, they didn't look at this during the studies. There isn't any, the vaccines aren't fully approved. All of the studies show that COVID vaccines have no impact on the ability to get pregnant. They don't cause miscarriage. Vaccines are not concentrated in the ovary. They don't damage the eggs. They don't interfere with embryo implantation. In fact, there hasn't been a single study which showed any negative impact of any vaccine on fertility. Spreading these lies causes people to avoid getting the vaccine, and that results in pregnant women ending up intubated in intensive care units. Innocent people end up dying. If you are watching this video, it is time for you to act. Share this information with your friends and relatives. Post it on your social media sites. Are you pregnant after vaccination? Post a selfie of your ultrasound or pregnant belly, hashtag pregnant after vaccination. COVID vaccines don't cause infertility. Shout it on the street corners. You know what? I am mad as hell at these anti-vaxxer lies. I'm gonna go do that right now. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.